Sediments are an important part of the natural dynamics in a river. When these dynamics are disturbed, erosion and sedimentation processes are no longer in balance. Strong erosion can lead to riverbed deepening. This affects nature, land use, and the water supply. If the riverbed deepens too much, man-made structures like bridges can become unstable. In order to reduce or stop erosion, there are different options. One possibility is to add material to the river by ship. However, the river will usually carry away the sediments. This means material needs to be added regularly. To reduce this repetitive effort, the coarse gravel enrichment method is being tested. The principle is to add gravel that is slightly coarser than the average size of the riverbed sediment. The power of the water mixes the coarser gravel with the existing sediments. Now the riverbed is more stable. This reduces riverbed erosion while enabling the transport of smaller sediment particles. Another possibility is to remove the fixed bank protection. The river can now erode the banks and widens. Material from the former protected banks moves into the riverbed. Now the riverbed is larger. The water spreads out and loses energy. This reduces the erosion. These are only three examples of how to reduce riverbed erosion. Now let's take a look at the opposite process. When the flow velocity of the river slows down, sedimentation increases, especially upstream of transverse structures. This can lead to a sediment deficit downstream. To compensate these effects, we need an innovative sediment management. This means sediments are transported through or around barriers in the river. A common measure is to excavate coarse bed load like big gravel and stones. These are reintroduced into the river downstream of the barrier. While fine sediments and small gravel can be extracted with innovative methods like hydraulic dredging. Modern sediment management aims to achieve a near-natural transport of sediments. This means that even during slightly higher flow conditions, gates are opened. Now deposited sediment can be remobilized. Nowadays, innovative hydropower plants can be built which try to avoid sedimentation altogether. One example is the so-called movable hydropower plant, which can be applied in rivers with low weirs. When medium to high flow conditions occur, bed load starts to move in the riverbed. Then the turbine is lifted, and the sediments can pass underneath the power plant. These were only a few examples of how to reduce sedimentation. Are you interested in finding out more? Visit our website. There you will find other good practice measures and further information on how to improve the sediment balance of the Danube River.